So we are going to do Grand Canyon Swing today. This is On the Trail, and this is the bass clarinet excerpt coming right up now. So, Grand Canyon Suite. You can find it in this book. This is Michael Drapkin's Symphonic Repertoire for the Bass Clarinet, Volume 1. I've had this book since I was in high school. And let's find it here. I had it a second ago. Okay, Grand Canyon Suite. Now, the things that are difficult about this are numerous. First of all, it's fast tonguing. Second of all, it starts up in a not great note, B flat. Third of all, you have to play it exactly the same tempo as the oboe that comes before you, so that means that you have to practice it with a metronome. Now, first of all, so let's start with the metronome part. Let's figure out how fast it goes based on this recording, which is Seattle Symphony and Jerry Schwartz. So here we go. Here it comes. So that's at about 144. Nice average tempo for this. But, you would probably want to listen to a bunch of different recordings of it, but that is really the average tempo, and this is the first excerpt of the two animato. The second actually goes a little bit faster. It's in the 150s, but we'll get to that in a second. So, knowing that our goal is 144, let's actually turn our tempo down to about 100. Now, you might want to start a little bit slower because it is pretty difficult, but remembering, you have to be able to play it perfectly with a metronome if you are ever going to stand a chance of making this through an audition. So, first note. That is not the easiest note to start on. So let's just practice doing that B flat in time. I'm going to give two bars for nothing, and then we're going to play it. Okay, one, two. It's even better if you can have the triplets going. That's a very difficult note to play because it's in this range up here where you have to really spend a lot of time figuring out what the voicing is. If you need to learn about voicing, check the rest of my videos. I talk about it about a billion times, so I won't talk about it here. Now, the next thing that you might want to do when you're practicing this is just practice the first of every beat. So you can play that in time. Again, giving yourself two bars for nothing because that's what the oboe does. I'll put the triplets back in. Here we go. Now the goal with this is to be able to play consistent articulations from the top all the way to the bottom. You don't want to start like long and flabby, or you don't want to end long and flabby. You want to be able to play them all the same short, crisp way. Making it through an audition, playing it perfectly. Okay, so that's just the first half of this excerpt. The second half is this sort of lopey horse thing, which has a ritardando. The thing that I notice a lot of students do is playing this from the F to the F sharp. Now, you can play it with the side F sharp, but that's actually not the easiest way to get back to the next note. aside isn't so easy. You're going to have to get good at playing F to F sharp without hearing a G in the middle. You don't want to hear that. So that's probably something you're going to have to work on as well. So here's the whole thing again. At tempo. Oboe, two. Okay? And then the second one, which is basically the same as the first, just faster. I'm going to put this at about 152. Could even go faster. It's the same, except faster, and the final, the second half of it is, the notes are a little bit different. Here we go. Same thing with the oboe coming in, so you have to play perfectly in time. One, and. Bass Clarinet excerpt. This is one that is on every audition, so it's obviously one that you're going to want to learn. Hope this was helpful, and we'll see you next time.